Welcome to Drawfee, where we take dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Nathan.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Karina.
And I'm Julia.
And we're a pretty fun cast of characters here. we're kind of fun.
Nathan, Karina said no. I'm sorry.
You know, and that's sort of part of the fun dynamic that
no,
we
it's
have.
Not. Is it's not fun.
That like one of us will say a thing and then we'll contradict it and it's sort of, I don't know, Nathan.
Julia's hemming and hawing.
But when you come
she's doing it.
She's hawing, there it is.
She went aww. Full haw. Whole haw.
My cat did not like that.
Today's suggestion comes to us from Fox Metro on the Patreon Discord, who says take an entire cast of characters and merge them into one person.
Aww.
Aww. So that's what we're doing here.
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 We're gonna merge.
Yeah, we should all say that at the same time.
Yeah, let's try it. See if we're all one. If you merged all of us.
What are we saying?
That's what we're doing.
That's what
here.
We're doing
okay.
here.
Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1.
That's what we're doing here.
Wait, I missed it. What are we doing?
Perfect.
Jacob, you're up first.
I'm up first.
What's a more iconic cast of characters than the cast of the hit 90s sitcom Seinfeld?
Seinfeld. I know that one.
I know they got four sort of main characters on that one, but what if they were one?
That's a really good question.
What if they were fused into a single person?
Hey, fusing them into one single person, you know what you get? You get a Newman.
There you go. Got him.
Newman.
You get Newman.
So
it's already been done.
Drawing Newman.
Their villain is just, it's just what if all of them were one person and that person was Wayne Knight.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm getting into it.
Hello, okay. Jerry Lane, George Kramer all at once.
That's what he's saying. We have to think of what their combo name would be. And I think it would be something like Dre Lord.
I thought you were it'll be something like
Krillane
Stanza. Krillane
Stanza.
Is this a bad episode?
No.
Or is it?
We literally just started. You can't announce a bad episode so fast.
Yeah. At least draw something bad if you're going to do that.
Yeah.
Get on it.
Really heck us up, Jacob.
Yeah.
I'm
derail
working on it
now.
Here. I feel like we gotta have they're gonna be smiling.
Yeah.
Because they're always, you know, cracking jokes.
Yeah, they're joking around always.
In that program. So I feel like face wise, I don't have a lot of places to go. They kinda have except for George, they kinda have similar faces.
They yeah. all have face.
They all have a face.
They've got like 90s face.
Yeah, they've all got peak 90s face. But I think where it's really going to come around is like the hair.
Oh, sure.
The hairs and like the bodies. This also seems to like indicate that in the show, it was just one person in an apartment alone. Having
oh,
all
yeah.
of these like.
Cool adventures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or I guess not cool adventures because that's literally not what they did.
No.
That was yeah, the exact
like
opposite point.
Cool
the opposite
adventure.
Of what they did.
They blew things out of proportion that were completely mundane.
Which is kind of like a cool adventure.
Yeah, it's like a mind adventure.
Wow. Damn, guess I go on a lot of cool adventures. I didn't know that.
Okay, so we're getting some thick eyebrows here.
Yeah, I'm looking at like Jerry's brows, Kramer's brows, And I think they both kind of have the thickness. Yeah. They bring the thickness.
Wow.
They're down with the thickness.
Yeah. Good one.
Thank you.
Okay, here's where it gets tricky.
Yeah.
I want to combine all the hairstyles.
Okay.
So I think it has to be sort of like...
receding hairline.
Yeah, bald in the front.
Bald in the front for sure.
So we're going to sort of bring this... get...
and then it goes straight up.
Yeah, then it's got to go straight up. But like sort of like back here.
Yeah, it's George's hairline and then Elaine and Kramer is sort of up.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
then
Jerry's the mullet.
Jerry's yeah. back.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
This is the new mullet. It's nothing in the front.
There's no party. There's no business.
Overdone in the back. Or in the middle and then party in the back.
Wow, this is something.
Yeah.
You see this and you know you're looking at something.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Krillane.
Krillane sign stanza. You can't tell me I'm wrong. Oh, what about glasses, though? I kind of think glasses.
Only one out of three has glasses.
But Elaine sometimes has glasses. Sometimes Elaine wears
glasses.
That's
true.
Sometimes Elaine wears glasses.
This is kind of starting to look like just like a... like a person you'd see in Williamsburg.
Yeah.
We know you're out there.
I've definitely been to a bar where they were the bartender.
Oh, God.
Damn, this is kind of fresh.
Yeah, this is kind of cool. If you combine...
this is a gentle cyberpunkman.
Very gentle.
I think I want like a more relaxed looking.
Wait, are these asymmetrical glasses? I wasn't paying attention. I was checking my email.
What the hell?
Sorry.
You were checking your email?
You were checking your email in the middle of an episode?
To check your email.
You wait until after the episode. It's common knowledge.
I have a life, you know.
No, they're not supposed to be asymmetrical.
Imagine if they were, though, to account for only one pair of glasses between four.
But sometimes Elaine.
But sometimes
okay. Elaine.
So two.
Yeah. Well, sometimes two.
Sometimes two.
Once, twice, sometimes Elaine.
I like it, so I'm keeping it.
Yeah. They can do what they want. Yeah.
They all have dark eyes.
Yeah.
From what I can tell. George is kind of squinting.
Yeah.
So I can't really tell for sure.
this is doing it.
It's a friend, I think.
And then what's like the outfits? Jerry's always wearing like a button down.
90s.
It's a lot of denim. A lot of denim button ups.
Denim button down. Elaine likes to wear the big sort of baggy blazer. That's sort of her look.
Yeah, totally.
Kramer's usually wearing a trench coat.
And Kramer?
Kramer?
Kramer's got the, like, wears the sort of, like golf, not golf, but, like Hawaiian shirts, but not.
Like thrift shore.
Can y'all calm down?
Can you get this episode together?
I'm gonna call them dad shirts.
He wears kind of dad shirts. Well, there is an episode where he gets a lot of Jerry's dad's old shirts, I think, or maybe George's dad's old shirts.
Someone's dad's old shirts
end up on Kramer, and then the dad is like, "I want my shirts back," and Kramer's like, "Buh."
So this is gonna be a big blazer on over the dad shirt, like a double collar.
Oh yeah!
Whoa!
Situation
again, very, very Brooklyn.
You can go to this guy's bar; he'll make you some cocktails.
Gonna get like a little
those cocktails
shine.
Will also have shirt collars. that's part of the shtick.
Wow.
It's really shiny,
polished.
Yeah.
Damn.
This is good. Jacob, you did well.
Krillane
is here.
Krillane. They've arrived.
My favorite Dragon Ball Z character.
I feel like they should be holding
my favorite
something.
Disney villain.
Oh, okay, maybe they
Cruella
just
plus
Krillin.
Cruillin.
It's our next video, combining Dragon Ball Z and Disney characters.
It's okay, what the people have been clamoring for.
I think that'd do pretty good.
This is just sort of a what's the deal hand.
Yeah.
What's the deal?
What's the deal with when four people merge into one?
Are you going to put like a red brick background in the render?
Oh, because he's like doing stand-up?
He always starts the episodes off stand-off. Stand-off?
Stand-off.
Face-off. It's face-off. It's Nicolas Cage's face-off.
We shouldn't be recording today.
No.
None of us can say anything.
What are you
anything.
Talking about?
Everything we say is wrong and
you
stupid.
You should put a fireball in that hand. This is your Spock fireball summoning hand.
Yeah.
No, it's a what's the deal hand.
No, I recognize it.
What's the deal with when I summon fire from the very ether of existence? Fire from nothing.
Maybe it's like a flaming question mark.
Oh.
God, you gave him the microphone and my opinion of this person went down significantly.
Yeah.
You said he was doing stand-up and he summoned a flaming question mark with
you
which
didn't
to
have
ask,
to like
what's
include
the deal?
It. We're just riffing.
I'm trying to have fun here with my friends.
Boo.
Don't.
Sorry.
Get
this
off
work.
The stage.
We're not here for a good time or a long time.
You know when you're trying to have fun with your friends and they start booing you?
I do. I know.
We know, Jacob.
A Larry, what's their name? Krillane.
Krillane.
Oh, Larry.
I know what you're talking about. Krillane, I get it.
This is good, Jacob.
This is very good.
Thank you. I'm done. Who wants to go next?
Me?
Okay, Karina, for you, I would like to see combined the cast of Yu-Gi-Oh.
Who would have thought?
Which Yu-Gi-Oh?
The dealer's choice.
You gotta do the classic.
I feel like
Yu-Gi-Oh
yeah.
main.
You don't want to do like Yu-Gi-Oh triple drains, Brexit. Smexel, whatever they're called.
As much as I love Yu-Gi-Oh! Smegma, I gotta do the original.
The classic Yug.
The Yug.
The one I've seen some of. Yeah.
I've seen some of it too. Most of it, probably.
A lot of people have seen some of it. It is quite popular when we were kids. Yug.
Yo,
Yug.
We were popular, Yug? I'm just the guy from Brooklyn.
I'm calling it right now. I feel like we're going to get another person you might see in Brooklyn.
Like Joey Wheeler.
Like Joey.
And that person is Joey Wheeler. So it's definitely got to have some Joey in there. Got to have Yugi.
Yeah.
Got to have Kaiba. Oh, that's going to make it complicated because of the 13-inch height difference. I guess that doesn't factor
split
in.
The difference.
Yeah, we're not showing the full height, so.
But it's short King Summer.
So he's just very average height.
Yeah.
Yeah, put him right in the middle.
He's is just the, like me for real.
Is the fourth spicy character you're mixing them with a Blue Eyes White Dragon?
Oh.
Can you imagine?
My favorite Yu-Gi-Oh character.
And also I can fly now, Yug.
And
I'm
also
a dragon.
I am Yug.
I am Yug.
Yug. I was thinking Bakura, but we'll
oh,
see.
Okay.
We'll cross that bridge when we get to it.
I am Yug and Yug are I.
Okay. See, I just need to mash up all their hairstyles, which is just going to result in your average Yu-Gi-Oh character of Zexal Arc 5 era. That's when the hair was really weird.
Do you think that's what they did? Do you think that's how they got it?
Oh.
Maybe they just mashed it up.
Yeah, maybe we're too late. They did it already, and it's called Zexal.
You're going to make the main character of Zexal.
Okay, it's a challenge to make the main character of Zexal out of nowhere. That's some weird They just get really structural with the hair in future seasons. That's all I'm saying.
Had to hire architects to design it. Yeah.
Structurally sound. Is this hair? Is this?
Yeah, I feel like in the original series, it was really just Yugi that had the hair that didn't make any sense.
What the hell?
And everyone else's hair made some sense.
I looked up Zexal main character hair. Yuma? I sure don't. It looks like he's got two ice skating blades on his head.
Yeah, he's a bit of a mess. He's indefensible, what can I say?
But he can do some pretty cool skate tricks on the ice.
With his head.
With his head.
Okay. I'm going to have to leave notes for myself. This is going to be white, yellow, yellow. Okay.
Okay.
But those aren't part of the design.
Those are notes.
Those are just notes for future Karina because she loves opening a document and getting some alarming information.
Don't render WYY into the final piece.
Yeah.
Unless.
Okay. Because Yugi has little baby eyes. But everyone else has pretty sharp eyes.
Sharp baby eyes.
Sharp
baby
eyes.
Yeah, we have to make a sharp baby.
When you were sharp, but also baby.
Do you think if Yugi and Kaiba were combined, they would tear themselves apart? Like they couldn't exist in that state?
Mm.
Or would it be like perfect unity?
A perfect balance.
Well, they gotta.
Perfect Yugity.
Perfect Yugity.
I mean, that's already kind of like the running theme of Yu-Gi-Oh. Everyone has like multiple fellas.
They got some guys. Yeah, Yugi's already two guys.
Yugi's already two guys. Bakura's already two guys who hate each other.
Kaiba, just one guy, but ooh, what a guy.
What a guy he is.
It's a little it's a little much for one guy.
Yeah. Kaiba's one guy, but it's a lot.
Yeah.
May as well be two guys, you know?
Every day it's a lot.
Yeah. And they're doing fine, except Bakura, but you know what? He gets better. They're all fine. Everyone's fine.
They just want to play cards.
Kind of.
Kind of.
Yeah.
And take over the world via cards.
Yeah, some of them.
Send the cards into space.
It's like I say in my 75-minute defense of Kaiba on my personal YouTube channel. He's just a guy who wants to, like, just fuck around with cards. And then a bunch of LARPers show up. Like, Kaiba, did you know? Okay, I need to get back to this hair. Got to get some Joey in there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because he has, like, that. And... and then, because then Bakura has these like bunny ears. He does.
This is some hair.
Yeah. This is kind of the main character of Zexal now.
This is your your friend who like hasn't, who doesn't regularly brush their hair before leaving the house. We all know one.
Nathan.
I wish my hair looked like this.
Maybe you should brush it even less.
Yeah. Kaiba, I'm going to try brushing it less and see if it becomes Yu-Gi-Oh. Okay.
I am a staunch defender of Yu-Gi-Oh hair for the most part, especially early Yu-Gi-Oh. Isn't that weird? It's just very stylized artistically. I think Yugi's hair is like pretty straightforward. It's literally just blonde bangs and then black up. Like styled up in the back with red tips.
Yeah. It was kind of like a classic like scene look at the time to have like the bangs in the front and then the back spiked up.
Yeah.
That's what Yugi is.
That's all it is.
And I mean, he already comes to school wearing like all black and a choker, a leather choker.
Yeah.
Like, so he's a little freaky little goth boy.
Yeah. He's
as it is.
Alt as hell. Like it's pretty normal, I think. I think most Yu-Gi-Oh characters, you can break the hair down into realistic interpretations if you just use your brain.
But not Zexal, boy.
Yeah.
We can't do anything with that.
It starts to get, you have to take a lot more liberties in Zexal in Arc 5. Okay, so then this is brown. And This is the Joey hair. This is normal. This is good.
Hey, yeah, I'd like to get my hair cut. Can I get the Joey, please?
The Joey over here, but the Bakura over here.
I've divided my my head into quadrants.
Yeah, here's some reference for you.
I'll take a Joey in the back and then a Bakura top and sides.
And don't forget a little bit of Kaiba in there.
Yeah.
Okay, so the regular.
to ground it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bring it home.
So you're the boss.
What if it's the Joey shape, but the Yugi colors? This is just fun. I'm having fun.
Yeah. Seinfeld and Yu-Gi-Oh! Both shows with some fun hairstyles.
Very
to
similar.
Combine. They're both.
I don't
sort
know.
Of,
I've never watched Seinfeld, but I imagine
they're both shows about
so
nothing.
This is Fred. Yeah,
different kinds of nothing, but nothing.
Yeah. Nothing, nonetheless.
What's the deal with Blue Eyes White Dragon?
Have you met this Kaiba guy? He kidnapped my grandpa over cards. It's a children's game.
He's the Kaiba guy that'll kidnap your grandpa.
Yeah, keep this going. Keep this going while I draw, please. I'm begging you, please.
He kidnapped your grandpa? He kidnapped my grandpa.
He's the Kaiba guy who has so much money and who spends it all on cards.
This is more like a Jeff Foxworthy bit.
What is happening?
Julia's latched on to Kaiba guy and kinda guy.
Yeah.
Sort of sounding similar.
Yes.
I think it's good.
You're doing great, I think.
He's the Kaiba guy.
I'm told you're doing great. Keep up the good work, Julia.
We're getting some notes in right now. Yeah. They're saying you're doing great.
Yeah. He's the Kaiba guy that's not smarter than a fifth grader.
Oh, no. It's all happening. The comedic confluence.
So, Nathan, you're going to assign me some outdated... stand-up comedians, right?
Yeah.
Your
favorite.
You're getting the blue-collar comedy tour.
Yeah. My favorite cast of characters.
Everyone's. This is what our audience wanted. Yeah.
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 It's what they get, and it's what they deserve.
Should he be happy? Maybe he should. Okay, let's see. What is the temperaments I'm working with? Joey is happy. Yugi is happy. Kaiba is deeply, deeply unhappy. And Bakura, he's a fucked up little guy.
Perfect.
He's the Kaiba guy to have a feud with an Egyptian pharaoh.
He's the Kaiba guy to have two guys living inside his head. And they hate each other. You're the same guy. Get along.
If you own a multi-billion dollar company and spend all your time playing with cards, you might be a Kaiba guy.
Okay.
Kaiba sucks.
I'm a Kaiba defender.
You know, Pegasus is also a Kaiba guy.
He's kind
oh
of a Kaiba
guy. God!
Because he's also super rich billionaire and spends all his time playing cards.
Yeah. And they both love their family.
That's one way of putting it, yeah. Okay, now we get to be creative. Did you know that for Yugi... Kazuki Takahashi was inspired by Edward Scissorhands.
Oh,
I could see
that.
Yeah, that's exactly why it looks like that.
Did Edward Scissorhands cut his hair?
I mean, look at this guy.
Okay, this is...
Whoa. Because that's a thing. I said Edward Scissorhands.
Sure did. I was just going to let it fly. It's not the worst thing we've said today.
No.
We're really nailing everything today. Sorry, I have a Google image search of Yu-Gi-Oh! Cast up on the screen in front of me, and it's very overwhelming. I'm having, like, sensory overload right now.
Yeah, right.
It's a lot of colors.
Towards the middle, there's just Bakura glaring at me.
It's kind of my, that's my resting spot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's right there.
It's like, hey, babe.
Who's... Karina right now is like Ozymandias and watching, yeah. looking at her million screens.
It's all Yu-Gi-Oh.
It's all Yu-Gi-Oh.
Always has been.
Who's American Joe down there?
That's Bandit Keith.
Oh, that's right, Bandit Keith.
In
no, I don't retain information.
American Joe.
Yeah, you did draw Bandit Keith.
Yeah, it was really funny.
I like to refer to him as Sloppy Joe. Sloppy like the food.
Joe. His name's not Joe.
He is to me.
To me?
To me.
He's Joe. Sloppy Joe.
Can we get a a little on screen of the Love Actually guy?
To me, you're Sloppy Joe. It's Julia holding it up and Keira Knightley
at the window. Oh, he's so ugly.
Oh, no. He's a lot, but so is this Google image search screen.
This is what happens when Karina looks at every Yu-Gi-Oh character that Google can throw at her at one time.
I like that this could plausibly be just another Yu-Gi-Oh character.
Yeah. Oh,
also.
100%.
Like, if you told me there was another Yu-Gi-Oh series and this was one of the characters, I'd be like, sure.
I believe you.
Yeah. This is the main character of Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged. They abridged the characters into one character.
I do firmly believe that if you combined all these characters, they would still just sound like Joey.
Joey's
voice is too powerful.
Would take over,
It would be Bakura's voice, who's like he's the posh one, but it would have Joey's accent and like the way he speaks.
How do you do posh Brooklyn?
Figure it out.
Posh Brooklyn is the name of a celebrity baby.
Oh, you mean David Beckham's son?
Yeah, posh Brooklyn.
He's the type of guy who would name his baby Posh Brooklyn.
I'm going to leave a note that says Posh Brooklyn, and we're going to see if I know what that means.
I can't wait to get a Discord message that says, does anybody remember what Posh Brooklyn means?
Remember.
Mufasa, the clouds part, Mufasa says, remember.
Yeah.
Posh Brooklyn.
Okay, I think this is... It's got to start with you because he is a Yu-Gi-Oh protagonist.
Okay.
You. What?
Yeef.
Why? Keith's not in it.
Keith's not part of it. He does have Keith energy, though.
Yeef.
This is a you yeet. Goodbye.
Yeet.
<I'm> done.
Can you please yeet yourself out of the seat?
Oh, I'm trying.
So we've done a live action sitcom. We've done an animated show. Uh-huh. Julia, I would like a video game for you. And I know you like The Legend of Zelda.
I sure do.
They got some good characters there. You know, Link, Zelda. Mm-hmm.
Gamendorf.
Gamendorf.
Yeah, there's a lot of...
Mr. Gamendorf.
Tingle.
Tingle.
Tingle Dingle.
Yeah. Tingle Dingle, Uncle Ruby, Pinkle, and the dog one.
And Stinkle.
All of my favorite Zelda characters.
Demon Train.
Okay, I think I'm just going to go.
Okay.
You're just going to go.
Bye, Julia.
I'm going to leave.
It was fun seeing you.
Bye-bye. This is your apartment, but bye.
Okay. All right.
Skull Boy.
Yeah.
Skull Kid.
Skull Kid even is what he's called.
Ben Drowned.
Ben Drowned.
He's a character, right?
Yeah.
Julia already drew Ben Drowned.
Oh, yeah.
That I did.
The old man in the cave who gives you the sword.
The horse. Yeah.
The horse, Epona.
Yeah.
Chicken.
What about chicken?
The chicken that kill you.
Yeah.
You hit the chicken and it kill you.
And the shark I've seen a lot of fan art for.
The horny shark.
Yeah, Tridon. The one who's... PPP, I definitely haven't seen seen.
To clarify, the shark himself is not horny. It's everyone else.
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't have a choice.
Everyone saw the shark and lost their minds.
Everyone's horny for the video game shark? What happened to being horny for real sharks?
That's what Shark Week's about, right? Late night Shark Week. I broke Jacob with that.
Late night shark week.
Late night shark week. Thank you. Well, I do feel like I have to do the shark.
Yeah, okay. So we're definitely starting with a shark shape.
Yeah.
Shark shape.
This is an interesting.
On the head.
Place to begin.
An interesting sure place is. To begin, yeah.
I chose sort of a very open-ended.
I have a lot of characters to choose
yeah,
from.
Yeah, Zelda, really, you have sort of an embarrassment of riches in terms of characters to choose from. So, yeah. So far, we're just getting Shark.
I got to get this fin shape just right.
Yeah, of course.
Shark first approach.
Yeah, shark shark out.
I'm going to shark out.
Okay, then it turns into like a little helmet.
Sharked out.
Sorry, I sharked out. Live on camera in front of everyone.
We're in the middle of recording and you just sharked out.
Yeah, that's kind of cringe.
I'm sorry.
Just looking at the references Julia has pulled up.
You know?
I'm very excited to see where this is going.
She's developing a treat for you, the viewer.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Hello?
Sure.
That's not the shark.
Hello!
Thank you!
So, the eyes go up over the oh
they have cartoon eye rules
oh
eye
yeah.
rules more like high rule
hey
oh
eye rules whatever happened to high rule
he's wow. the kind of guy
okay they're like really circular though there we go
so this better. Is Beetle.
Yeah.
We're getting a beetle. So far, the two characters of the... I don't know how... I guess we've all done four.
Yes.
So far.
Should they be closer? I feel like they should be much closer.
Beetle's eyes touch.
Yeah. Like
I mean,
science.
I did hide a bit of Ojama yellow in mine. You'll just have to find it.
Is that
Where
what...
Where did you put it?
That's what Posh Brooklyn meant.
Yeah.
They meant hide Ojama yellow.
It was somewhere. A code phrase.
So Beetle and Sidon, the two sort of, when I think of Legend of Zelda.
When I think of Legend of Zelda hunks.
The two protagonists.
The two sort of main central figures of the series.
Yeah.
it's like a Muppet.
He is. That's why I was laughing.
Got the frecks.
Yeah, got them freckles.
Oh, God, he's so goofy.
He sure is.
He's a silly fella.
Yeah.
I love how long you spent, like, getting this cool, like, foreshortened angle of Sidon's top fin and then just stuck the eyes right on it.
I sure did.
It's really good.
It's like he's wearing a graduation cap.
Maybe he is.
You did it. You got all the beetles, Beetle. Oh, but he's got pointy ears.
This is a traffic cone.
Oh. Oh, is that my boy? My little guy.
Is it little Stinkle?
Stinkle. Yeah.
So he's got the little cheek swirlies over the freckles.
Inside.
Good for him.
Inside the freckles.
That's another Brooklyn look.
Oh, yeah. The freckles. Sort of, yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Mystical.
Yeah.
That's design.
Oh my God.
Wow.
That's a very hesitant smile.
Okay. Maybe not that smile.
The smile of someone who's been hurt before. Oh, never mind. Now it's just the cast smile.
Yeah.
Now it's the smile of someone who's going to hurt you.
Call an ambulance.
But not for me.
Stare. I somehow captured the energy of Elf on the Shelf.
It's kind of... it's also kind of SpongeBob.
Yeah, I could see that.
Oh, yeah.
It's giving me a little... I know it's not SpongeBob, but it's just giving me a little SpongeBob, sort of making me be like, you remember SpongeBob?
Hey, 90s kids, you remember SpongeBob?
90s kids remember SpongeBob.
90s kids remember.
90s kids have incredible memories. They remember so much.
We just can't forget.
90s kids can't forget. Try as they might. 90s kids are cursed with remembrance.
I feel like I lost Sidon in here somehow.
No, you'll find him again.
Yeah, he'll be back. Just give him that hot bod. It's what he needs right now.
Yeah.
Wait, so if it's Sidon, Tinkle, and the Beetle. Other, the Muppet, Tinkle, the other guy.
Tinkle.
Who's your fourth?
Yeah, we know. The fourth. Remains a
spit
mystery.
Spit it out.
We're waiting.
I'm noticing, God. You know, just sort of no Zelda or Link
yes.
so far. So I'm
right.
I'm feeling doubtful that it's gonna be either of them at this point, but who knows?
Well, this is the main three I've
right.
Got.
Well yeah. clearly.
Yeah, so the fourth will be sort of a wild card.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's hard with a game series that spans multiple games to try and pick the four most Zelda characters. But yeah. I think
I would definitely yeah. pick Tinkle first.
Tinkle.
Yeah.
How's this?
Oh,
it's Ganon.
It's
Mr. Gamendorf.
It's Mr. Gamendorf.
We have to get the villain.
Mr. Game and Watch. I love that guy.
He's gonna take us to what is it? The sausage nightmare? The meat train.
Meat train.
Meat train.
Sausage nightmare. yeah, this one goes out to all the people who don't know what that means.
If you played Smash, you have a good idea.
It's Karina's edge guarding strategy with Mr. Game and Watch.
And when it works, it's infuriating.
I've never drawn anything more threatening than this.
I wouldn't want this person to have their googly eyes zero in on me, I'll tell you that much.
Don't look at me with your googly eyes.
This is like 10 times more threatening than the Joker.
Yeah.
The Joker is shaking in his boots.
Yeah. If the Joker looked up and saw this face looking back at him, he'd be like, I've been out-joked.
I gotta go.
I gotta go. I'm in mortal danger. Oh my God, that shoulder.
So big. He's a big man.
Okay. That's what I wanted. As long as he's got the hot pod.
Yeah, he's
big.
It's I think what's happening is Sidon's body and Ganon's body are having sort of a multiplier effect on
yeah.
each other.
Yeah.
So
good.
It's just really thick.
Would you say that maybe it's down with the thickness?
Wow.
He's definitely down.
Yay!
What a precious little face, though.
Yeah. That feeling when you see the beetle and you must have it.
You're not escaping me this time. I've been training. Beetle doesn't even have beetles.
No, he wants the beetles, though. When you get the beetles.
Does he want beetles?
Yeah, if you show up to Beetle with a bug in your inventory, he's like, wow!
Oh, that's right.
Give me that! Now! Now!
Ganon knows.
Hurry!
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. A combination
I like,
of like
it. I like it. But yeah. It's rosy, like Tinkles.
Yeah.
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 Rosie nosy.
Rosie oh. nosy.
He's like the Count from Sesame Street.
Yes. I've drawn the perfect in between a Wallace and Gromit character and a Muppet.
And then you just
I
gave
like him
some big shoulders.
Yeah. I like to think that he has a helmet. And then when he takes it off, this is, you expect him to be like, to look like Ganon, but this is what's underneath it.
I've got the perfect name.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Yeah.
Binklendorf.
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 The ultimate villain, President Heart of Darkness.
Binklin.
Binklendorf.
Binklendorf.
Abraham Binklendorf. Binklendorf.
God. Yeah, great.
I did vote for him.
Yeah.
This is my president.
This is my president. I mean,
not afraid to show my president.
His platform of I will suplex you if you don't vote for me was pretty effective. The E is on his
bot.
Bot. What do you want?
What do you want from Binklendorf?
No one knows what his platform is, but they're scared to vote against him.
He just stares at you in all the commercials.
It's just
the slow
it's
zoom.
Just this image, and it zooms in.
Yeah,
and
it with gets like slightly, ambient noise.
Yeah, just.
And then at the end, you have a woman's voice that comes out and says, "Vote." You're like, "Damn, I will though. I guess
you got me."
I feel like I can't afford not to vote for Binklendorf.
What's he going to do if I don't vote?
I don't know what he's going to do.
I have a request.
Yeah, what's up?
Because I'm just kind of curious, want to see it. Can we get the sort of fishtail coming out the back of the head?
The fishtail coming out the back of the head.
Because he's got the tails on his head.
Because the head is the shark and the rest of it is man.
Yeah.
I guess it could be from up there, yeah.
Oh, coming out the top of the cone.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, so all right.
If it doesn't work, you don't have to do it. I was just kind of curious.
I think it's
you know
cute.
What? Yeah, I think it's cute. I just have to figure out that's where that lives.
It's really tall. Binklendorf.
Binklendorf.
Abraham Binklendorf. Vote.
There we go.
I think it's good.
I think it's good. I vote that Julia did a good job.
This is Zelda.
I vote that too.
If you combine all of Zelda,
if you combine the main cast
characters.
Of Zelda,
the main cast, it's Binklendorf.
I think I did it.
Yeah.
Now we have to make a new show with these three characters,
and then combine those three
and
characters.
Then combine them.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
How would the show be? It would be similar to Seinfeld in that they all just kind of like live in the same apartment complex.
Yeah, they all live in Brooklyn. These are all people that you see walking around Brooklyn.
These are all people who hang out at the same apartment complex playing cards.
Yeah.
And
doing whatever Tinkle does.
Yeah, doing whatever Binklendorf does.
Yeah.
We can't think about that.
We can't. We can't break that down.
No, but if you want to write fanfic,
you know
free.
We read it.
Yeah.
Feel free.
We'll read it for sure.
But more importantly, if you like this, please like and subscribe. We also do a live Twitch stream on Mondays, 7 p.m. Eastern time. And if you really like us, support our Patreon. It's how we keep doing this channel. It's how we keep doing this show. Patreon.com.
You can combine with the other patrons.
Ooh.
Yes.
Into one super patron.
Wow.
Yes.
In the Discord.
In the Discord.
Yeah.
Wow.
And it'll look like these fellas.
It'll kind of look like, it'll maybe look a little something like this.
A friend group.
It's a friend group.
I have to not look at this face anymore.
No. Zoom in a little.
The eyes follow you.
They truly do. A modern day Mona Lisa.
Wow.
We're out of here.
We're sorry.
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 Vote.
Vote.
Vote.